Oh boy. Thank you, YouTube. Let me know when you guys can see me. Hello. Hi, D-Lan. Hi, Clark Fine Art. Hi, Kimmy B. Hi, George Pencil Art. Thank you all for joining me. I can't believe I'm doing this all over again. YouTube decided to not auto start like it normally does, like it's set to. I can see it right there. What's up, everybody? Welcome back to my studio. I'm Joseph Finchum. You're you. And you've been sitting there doing nothing for 10 minutes while I explained everything. Okay, this is Tom the Turkey. Tom the Terminator Turkey. He doesn't like people who decorate for Christmas in November. You wait till December 1st, then you start. I don't really care about this. It's just a joke. I'm not being serious. Today, I ran out of time, so I have to transfer it onto the bristle board, which I will then ink, and next week we'll probably color it in Photoshop. Excellent. You find it offensive. So I have to transfer it. I really wanted to get it done beforehand. I didn't. So, yeah. I've already done the face, the hat, the tail, most of the tail feather pieces. Yeah. See, it's funny because I said something, before, where was it? And I can't remember. I think maybe it was a D-Lin comment, but I said something, and D-Lin pretty much said something that responded directly to my question, so. Or to my statement, so I had absolutely no need, no understanding that YouTube had not started. Okay. So, back to tracing this guy. And I'm dealing with a glare issue here. I mentioned earlier, while you guys couldn't hear me, that there were some things I would be fixing while I was doing it. And the center lines that I'm putting in here are a couple of those things. This lead feels like it's about to fall out, which is weird. Okay. So now, most of the tail feather parts are done. Line right there. On this side, anyway. I find that acceptable, Rob, and thank you for joining. I appreciate you being here. Okay, so. Oh, this glare is gonna kill me. Why does this light feel so weird? Yeah, this is definitely pleasant. I need any old brush will do. Any old pencil will do, as long as it's got a point. I mentioned earlier that, so I drew the tail feather part, the bird's body, the one gun, and the face and hat all on different pieces of paper and had to put them together in Photoshop and then trace this right off of my monitor, which was not ideal. He could shoot desserts. We could make him do that. Oh yes, Tom Turkey is an angry bird. And every time I pause, I forget where I was drawing. So, that's not good. All these circles and circles, ugh. The bane of my existence. None of my circles are circles, and none of my straight lines are straight lines, so I'm trying to fix that while I transfer. But they don't have to be perfect. I definitely want it to look like it's drawn, you know? Hopefully you can tell what I'm doing. I know watching somebody trace is not the most entertaining of things to do. So please bear with me. But the coloring next week should be more fun. Hi, Tara. I hope you feel better. I hate not feeling well, so I get it. Looks like it got really messed up. At least we're getting somewhere. I hope. With my luck, none of this is transfer. Did I do this one already? Go ahead. And just so you know, all of the reference for these gun barrels is pulled directly out of my butt. I have no idea what a bunch of gun barrels would look like. I think I did that one. Oh boy. Tracing's fun, isn't it? Especially when you've already drawn the thing like 15 times. I think that side's done. I have no fingernails. We just get his foot down here, and I sharpen again, so give me a second to do that. Okay. Get the hat. Can't tell. I think I got the hat. Go back in there. may have done that wrong. None of these missile things are going to be shaped exactly the same. Hopefully the shapes are close enough, though. As long as they read similar, that's fine. You guys let me know if I'm boring you to tears. The leader of the Angry Birds. I didn't see that before. I'm not sure exactly what you're asking, George. If you're asking what I'm going to be doing with this, or if you're asking what I did to get it to here. To get to here, I drew pretty much everything separately. Gun barrels, bird body, bird face and head, tail feathers, and the legs were all drawn on separate pieces of paper, trying to figure out the right shapes. And then I just mashed it together in Photoshop by putting, this drawing in the back and then this drawing in the back, the legs on the next layer up, the body on the next layer up, the guns and the head on the next layer up, flattened it down, and then traced that to get to here. To go from here to coloring it in Photoshop, I will just take this once it's inked and I'll scan it right into Photoshop, and then that'll be my black outlines. And Bob's your uncle. Start color. I hope I answered one or both of your questions. We are still going, right? Yes. Okay. Over here. Look at that. I definitely did not do the insides of these barrels. Hopefully I can fix that in the inking. And yes, you can take a picture of it. The problem with taking a picture is your lighting has to be absolutely perfect, or you won't be able to, like, if you take a picture of just the pencils, it's like, some of it looks black, some of it looks gray, you know, and if you try and make it easier to see by changing the levels, you know, bringing in the white, making the white white, and the, making your lights light and your darks dark, stuff artifacts and gets weird. With inks, not so much. The inks pretty much do exactly what they're supposed to do, which is stand out. These are all so unstraight. I think that's right. Keep losing track of where I am. And I'm trying to do the Gatling gun, I guess you would call it, part first, last. The reason I drew this like 15 times is because of perspective. I hate perspective. There's always something to very easily go wrong. Almost done, I think. See a line right there? It's a good thing I remember what I drew. That ought to do it. There we go. With this style. Yeah, I've used GIMP. GIMP is pretty much the same thing. I don't know how much more advanced GIMP has gotten since Photoshop went to the Creative Cloud thing, the CC. So that's completely beyond me. And now we're just going to start inking. Never gave him his hook on the other side. His little back of the leg claw. Thank you for posting the link to the merch, Angela. This drawing right here might eventually become a piece of merch too. The way I picture it in my head is with text above it and below it that says, "Wait your turn, fat boy or fat man." I'm not sure which yet. This line is missing. Seems like there's a couple lines over here missing. Just gonna... Because he is supposed to be wearing a vest. I think I just went the wrong way with that one. Not supposed to be there. Photoshop will fix it. I know I'm just jumping all over the place, but I'm trying to work this as fast as I can, as to not completely bore you guys. Here. Every picture I saw of a turkey, they have some crazy eyes. In case you were unaware. Nice little pilgrim hat there. Let's see if I can. Huh, how about that? I don't know if I succeeded, but I was trying to make his fingers look like feathers. That's cool, D-Lan. Work away. You do whatever you need to do. He's an angry. Definitely mess that piece up a bit. As long as the basic shape is right. And when I color it, the coloring is done right. It should all come together. Did I mention that circles within circles are the bane of my existence? Yes, they are. Trying to give a bunch of round things dimension just means you gotta draw more round things. One minute. We'll have to fix that later. We doing on time here? Oh, not bad. I think I'm smudging the heck out of this. We're getting closer to being a complete actual drawing. We've got a whole bunch of them. He's angry because someone stuffed him. Tom the Terminator Turkey does not get stuffed. He does the stuffing. Hey, Simone Mac, thank you for joining. Luckily for you, you weren't here while I screwed everything up. Bad angle. Hold on. That is not a pretty line.
Gallivants.
We're actually getting somewhere. Look at that. The things you notice when you look up. At the other screen. Let's try and get a little closer again. Start over here. Every now and then, this marker is like spitting out. Very strange. So the Clark Fine Art, I saw the if you don't already, and it confused me. I was like, if I don't already, what? Hey, Teresa. As long as you don't mean that is some turkey, like that's some pig, crispy and lean, you know? Charlotte's Web, anyone? Okay. WoW is better. WoW is good. But this turkey definitely don't get eaten. He'd be too tough and gamey. Missing line. These things are definitely all changing shape. A woman on a beach? That could be interesting. Yeah, I can't say I've seen many photos of women fishermen, though. That's probably a tough one, George. Try fisherwoman. That might work. Fisherwoman might work. Somehow I messed up the perspective on this like scope looking part over there. Don't know how I did that. Either the paper moved while I was transferring it, or I just wasn't paying attention. Woman and fish. Yeah, that I can understand that bringing up mermaids. Does make sense. Normally, when I'm drawing, I'm taking a lot of breaks. I'm not taking any breaks right now. think that's supposed to be like that. So, who here is a big fan of Thanksgiving? I'm a big fan of Thanksgiving. I like Thanksgiving. Okay, truth be told, I just like turkey. I personally do not eat enough turkey, so I like things. Eat a bunch of turkey, take a nap, wake up, eat a bunch of turkey. Anyone else have a similar Thanksgiving tradition? We may actually get him inked. We're doing pretty good on time, as far as I can tell. Little bit. I did that wrong. And if you're wondering what I mean by I did that wrong, I went over the wrong one, because either I didn't draw it, or I didn't transfer it, or I've already rubbed it away and just couldn't see it, so I drew the line where I thought it would go, and that's not right. I could tell as soon as I did it, that's not where it should have been. Okay. I think that's everything I drew transferred. So, ugh. My hand is killing me. Yeah, I could see that. I could see that Clark Fine Art. That, yeah. Oof, no fruit, sugar, or carbs. I couldn't do it. Actually, I'm sure I could if I had to, but I don't have to, so I can't. Yeah. Grilled veggies, yeah. Stevia makes me. I am. Oh, I didn't know you were diabetic. My brother-in-law was, and my niece is. And stevia makes me sick too. But that's the best cranberry sauce there is. If you make homemade cranberry sauce, don't bring it here. It will not be welcome. I will throw it in the garbage. I am a jellied cranberry sauce kind of person myself. Too many, George. Too many. I don't know. There's like one, two, three, four sets of double barrel, I guess, shotgun type barrels. There's one, two, three rockets, one bazooka, one, two, three barrels there, one, two, three. Too many. He's holding too many guns. It's the. If you've ever seen the mask, Jim Carrey's, the mask, when he pulls out the guns and it's all the crazy guns and everyone goes running and hiding, and then he pulls the trigger and all the little bang flags come out. That's what I was thinking when I came up with the idea. So he's pretty good. There will be some stuff done that'll like blacken it down. I could see if I can do this lightly enough. Eyes are starting to bug out. Getting a little blurry. Because I'm using them too much. I'm not going to color this whole thing in this marker. It's a good marker. I'm not, but this will all be black with, a little highlight there. There will be some highlights on like the brim of the hat. Looks so rough. And the belt, the buckle, so this will be black. I could just do this. This will be black. These will be black. Some of the barrels will probably be darker, but most of them will be a dark gray. So there isn't going to be a whole lot of black, but there'll be some black, like, deep in here where I don't need to see some stuff. We'll definitely darken that up, but we'll figure it out as we go when we're coloring it. What time is it? At 4:47? Okay, well, it's a little earlier than I expected. Oh, thank you, Clark Fine Art. I did want to try. There, when I color it, there will be like a couple of little like strips, you know, to like make it look a little bit more feathery, you know. So hopefully that'll be good. Oh, D-Lin, I have been there many times. That I will go to. The Christmas, the tree lighting in Rockefeller Center, I will never go to again. I went there once. It started out sucking, turned into an absolutely great night, but that great night would never happen again. So, that's a story for a different time, I guess. But, yes, I've been there many times. My brother and his wife and daughter, they, I don't know, now she's in college now. Really? Really, man, with your engines? She's in college now, but up until she went away to college, they went every single year of her life. So she's been to that parade every year. They never go outside. They get a hotel that overlooks it and just watch. The Christmas tree lighting, I went to a Christmas tree lighting in Rockefeller Center, and they put you in pens, basically. And you were not allowed to leave these pens for any reason unless you are going to leave forever. So you're stuck there. And then it started raining, and it was pouring on us, and it sucked. And then a door, like a doorman at one of the hotels there was like, hey, you know, can one of you guys, like, go and get me some food from McDonald's? And we were like, we're not allowed out of the pen, you know, or we won't be allowed back in. He's like, if you come out of that line and go and get me food, I'll hook you up. So we got him food. We went back, gave it to him. He brought us up to a nice, basically a suite overlooking the tree and the stage and everything. And in that room was where they were storing all the gift baskets to give to other people when they got their hotel rooms for free. So we got, I mean, you know, they got the things for free when they paid for their hotel rooms, but we got everything for free. And the guy was like, everyone who's checked in is checked in already, so anything that's left in this room is up for grabs, have at it. And it was great, just for walking half a block, getting some McDonald's, and bringing it back to someone. So, okay, I think we're done here. It's not great. I like it. Don't get me wrong, I do like it. But you know me. Self-deprecating is a way of life. Yeah, it was definitely a good time then, but I'll never go again, because if it rains and it's freezing, who wants that? No one wants that. Macy's, it can still be a little warm. You know, not warm, but not December, end of December cold, or middle of December cold. I don't remember when they do that thing. And New Year's, I will never go to New Year's again either, because I've been stuck in the, I went to, tried to go to New Year's in Times Square 3 times in my life. Every time it has been raining on a freezing night. Should have been snow. It wasn't snow. It was pouring rain. Sucked. Never, ever, ever again will I even attempt that. Okay, so we're done. Thank you all for joining me. We're going to end it a little early. That's okay. Thank you, everyone, for joining me. Thank you to my patrons. If you are a patron, just to let you know, after this is over, at 5 o'clock, There will be a new video up on Patreon for early access. It's basically the grand finale of the skateboard video. Or skateboard project. So, if you want to check that out, feel free to. It'll go up live for everybody else on Friday. 3 p.m. same time. Check out Angela. She helps out here so much. And she streams Mondays at 3 p.m. So you can check her out too, you know, and watch her streams. Link should be in the description. I believe it is. If it's not, tell me and I will fix that. But it should be there already. But yeah, new video coming at you any minute now. I was hoping to actually go all the way to 5 o'clock so it would be right on the dot, but, you can't win them all. Thanks again, everybody. I really do appreciate you being here, and I'll see you next time. Bye.